more nice, relaxed, laid-back approach to this Japanese skill toy. So if you've come here looking for tips on how to land lighthouse or better techniques for lunar, this is actually not the video series for you, because we're looking for something very flowing, very relaxed, very laid back. Something that you can do when you're taking a break from your Netflix episodes, pick up your kendama and do a few very relaxed, simple moves. This is going to be the video series for you. So let's get started. Let's start with big cup. It's usually the first move that most of us learn on the kendama, and it's one we come back to over and over again. So, just using a regular grip, and of course big cup on top, we start with the tama resting nice and steady down below. And remember, we're always gonna use our knees to generate the move and also to cushion the catch. And let's go with big cup. Straight on like that, the pull is straight up, using our body. And that's another beautiful thing about kendama. Good for our body, good for our brain. And again, as we're emphasizing in this series, very relaxing. So, big cup, give it a try. Next, we can move on to little cup. Maybe you didn't even notice the kendama cups are not actually the same size. We started with big cup. If you just rotate the kendama around, we'll be having little cup on top, the string facing away from us. And again, just using a regular grip, bending our knees, we go down, up, and land little cup. So give that basic move a try. Again, these are building blocks that we'll use later for many of our other moves. Little cup. A third basic move, and a little bit harder than big cup and little cup, is base cup. And in this case, we can use a different grip. Kind of like a pen grip, as if we were going to write with the tip of the kendama. So, same principle again. Tom is resting at the bottom of the string, straight down from the can, or the main body of the kendama, using our legs. Base cup. One more time. Base cup. Give this one a try. Don't be frustrated. It's a little harder than the first two cups, but you'll get it with a bit of relaxed practice. Our final move in this video is a technique I call pendulum. It's also a very relaxing kind of technique, and you can do it once or twice, or try and have the tama go as many times as you can. So, pendulum looks like this. I hope you enjoyed this video and you come back for more. Kendamas for Grandmas. See you in the next video.